Hi Gen X, this is me, Amar Judgment. Today at Dialogue at Nation Next, we have with us Mr. Sudhakar Reddy, who was the man behind the camera for films like Sairat and Deool. Sudhakar Reddy is soon going to make his directorial debut with the Marathi movie Naal.
Subscribe to Nation Next YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get regular updates from Nation Next.
Welcome to Dialogue at Nation Next. Sudhakar ji, kaise hain?
Thank you.
All good?
All good.
नाड़ एक ऐसी स्टोरी है जिस आपकी स्टोरी है, आपने स्क्रीन प्ले किया है, आपने को प्रोड्यूस भी किया है, आप इसमें आपका डायरेक्टरियल डेब्यू है. सो वॉज मेकिंग दिस मूवी इन मराठी ऑलवेज द पार्ट ऑफ द प्लान?
राइट फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग आई डोंट थिंक आई हैव अ प्लान टू मेक इट इन मराठी. दिस स्टोरी इज रिटन वेरी लॉन्ग बैक, लाइक मे बी 15 ईयर्स बैक. I have this idea since quite some time, but I wrote it, I think, first draft and first draft is written 50 years back, I think. And then I started shooting films, and then I got busy in cinematography, and then I kept on writing. Whenever I get a time, I write scripts. So in between, I keep writing other stuff also. But when I thought ki I wanted to make this film, then I took out this older draft and then wrote the full draft.
So you saved the best for the last, I think, for your director debut.
So then, so when I thought of making it now, then I thought of doing it in Marathi. But initially when I was writing, I didn't think of any language. It's just a story which I wanted to tell, that's all. I thought it could be in Telugu, Tamil, Punjabi, whatever it is. But I'm not sure that time.
And what was the inspiration behind the story? I mean, it's a very, unique story. The name itself, Naal, which means the umbilical cord which connects the mother and the baby. So what was the inspiration behind writing the story?
The Melu and the what you see in the film, the village, and then it's quite similar to like the village which I come from, like Nadikoda village in Gadchiroli district in Maharashtra. So that's a Melu, and it's all set around that, and basically some of the incidents, some of the elements of the story, they are quite, some of them are from my life. Mm-hmm. But the story as per se is very fictional. Story is fictional, but the milieu and the setup is quite from my life.
So आपने कितने सारे roles play किए movie में? आप co-produce किए, आपने screen play लिखा है, आप इसको आपने direct भी किया है, और आप cinematography भी कर रहे हैं इस चीज की. तो what role did you enjoy the most?
While you're doing the film, you are all doing it together. You don't know when you are shifting from one role to other. You don't realize that only. So, because when you are geared up to tell a story, then you are just doing that. Sometimes, whatever you know as a cinematographer, just to take the camera and take start shots, and you know how to handle like the script and all. So you keep writing in between also. So you don't know when you shift. It's just that you want to tell the story. You want to tell the story. So you utilize whatever crafts you know, whatever skills you have, and tools you utilize and tell the story. I think that's it. You will never by yourself notice that there's a shift. Yeah, this is only an outside perspective. Other outside people can look at it like that. We don't realize it.
But did directing the movie came easy to you, because it was your story, and secondly you were on the camera, and you had a thought process in your mind, okay, I want the scene to be like this, I want the frame to be like this. So did directing the movie came easy to you that way?
I would say actually, like, because I'm a cinematographer, so I can visualize. Like if somebody gives me a page to read and then visualize it, I can visualize. So that's definitely one of the way you can easily make yourself comfortable to telling a story. But actually saying, the most thing which comes handy is writing. If you write a script by yourself, then it's more easy to direct.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I feel as of now. When I'll direct somebody else's story, then I'll know what is the difficult need. But as of now, I feel that that's the most comfortable way of getting into direction. If you write it, then you are already pre-lived the emotions which are going through. Then it becomes a little easier to direct, I think.
Tell us something about the movie, about Naal.
See, Naal is basically a story of a kid, and it revolves around his fantasy world. Like, it's not like real fantasy, but his soul, he has this exuberant life, and then he has go through certain kind of emotional turmoil in his very small span of small time.
Mm.
And it's about his mother and himself. So it's the whole film is from the point of view of the kid.
Mm.
So what is going through, what is the way it's shot like that also. It's been developed that also. Every scene there is kid. And then with the camera is also trying to show what he feels and how he sees the world.
Mm. The kid is a very mischievous kid in Naal, and you know, so while writing this character, I mean, did you take anything from your childhood as well? I mean,
lots,
anecdotes.
Lots,
so what kind
lots.
Of anecdotes did you take? I mean, if you
not anecdotes, but incidents from what you yourself did, or mm-hmm. or your friends did,
mm-hmm.
and you have things you observe from other kids and all. So I think that's all. You collect it and then put it in the film.
Now coming to the star of the movie, Srinivas Pokhale. When you started shooting for the movie, he was 7 years old. And you know, there are people like Nagraj Manjule in the film. There's Devika Daftardar in the film. How difficult was it to shoot the movie with this 7 year old kid? Was it difficult? Was it easy? If you're shooting with a senior actor, you can just tell him that, you know, okay, you know, we have to do it like this. But you cannot possibly reason it out with a 7 year old. So how difficult was it?
With the Krishna, there is one thing. I already worked with kids earlier also. So that time, I had little experience with the kids of how, and also other films when I was shooting. There are kids in other films also which I shot.
Mm.
So taking that experience, what I feel is always is when you're talking about the kids, you want to cast a kid. It's very important to get a kid who is like your character. Then you have a little lesser task to explain him on the to like get him into the character. So it's always good to find a character in the kid you're looking for. Don't do otherwise. Mm. That's what I feel.
Mm.
So this is the kid I was visualizing when I was writing. So I got a kid who is quite similar to so that becomes little easier.
Mm.
Otherwise you can't make them act.
Mm.
Kids has to be natural by themselves. So you see the spirit of your character mm-hmm. in the kid and then get that kid. The only task is to like keep them physically active
mm-hmm.
through the shoot and go through the entire process of shooting.
Mm-hmm.
That is a really challenging thing.
Mm-hmm.
Luckily, she is like a very energetic kid. He never gets tired.
Mm-hmm.
Like he wakes up at 5:30, 6 o'clock and he sleeps at 11:30. So that's how he was. They're really lucky with this kid. And then he's super talented. And also he has a great memory. Whenever you want to do a scene, we'll be shooting randomly. You know, like in film shooting, we shoot one scene now, and then the next 40th scene we'll shoot immediately the next day, next year, or next hour or something. But it's very important for the kid to remember which scene is where. And it's very rare for the kid. He remembers every scene in the film. Like, after 5 days of shoot, he knows every scene in and out. Now what we say, I'll tell you first sentence of the scene. Now you'll go there and say, lie them, and I'll go lie them, and then mother comes, this. He tells everything.
I am sure many people, you know, who would see the movie, who have seen the trailer, they must be wondering, I mean, how exactly did you find the right kid? This thing that you just spoke about, it is important that the character that you thought of, you get exactly the same person. How do you search for Srinivas?
We've gone to like about 200 schools around Bandara, Amravati, and Nagpur.
Mm.
And then we used to go to this, we have a couple of people helping us also. There's a friend called Praveen who's assisting me.
Mm.
He's doing the casting and all. So he has gone to many, many schools, and we also went to many, many schools, and we start to drive, and while we are looking for the locations, we used to go to village and then first see, look for the location, and then we gather at the near some school or some tree or something, and then call the kids of the village and just talk to them, ki, what's your name, and then you know how to sing, so you make engage with them, and then they will open up. And ask them to do what they generally used to do. So then they open up and then they slowly know which kid is sharp and which kid is more expressive. Like that we auditioned about 300-400 kids actually.
Oh.
Out of them we selected 5-6, and then it's a long process.
But he's a complete natural, I must say. We have seen the trailer and that he's a complete natural.
He's like the most natural kid.
But it was his first time as well facing the camera. So was he scared? I mean, if he was scared, what would you tell him? I mean,
those things, see, obviously they will be little, yeah. They won't be scared, I say they will be definitely like little nervous. Those things you have to definitely make comfortable with them. Like you just
what do you do? Give them a candy or what?
No, by the time the shoot, they come to the shoot, they will be off those things. Mm-hmm. Because you'll have to make them comfortable right even before you start shooting only. You can't be start.
So is there some sort of training that goes into it?
Yeah, we do one small workshop and then with himself alone and other kids, and then also with the other characters of the films, you do some small these workshops like them, then they'll get comfortable. They know that there's going to be camera, then they know that there's going to be lights and all. So it's all important just to make them understand ki shooting aisa hota hai. That's good enough, I think.
You were born in Guntur, you then studied at FTI Pune. You have short films like Sairat and Deool. Sairat went on to become one of the biggest blockbusters in Marathi film industry. How did Marathi cinema happen to you? I mean, you went back after, you know, you finished your degree from FTI Pune. You went back, you shot Telugu films. How did Marathi cinema on such a huge scale happen to you?
When I was in shoot, I've been part of like the Marathi friends I have. Like a lot of other Marathi, because in Pune we all interact with some of the people. So that's how I know a couple of people from Marathi. And also after the institute, I went back and started shooting Telugu films and all. But I felt ki there is certain kind of format we, that time definitely is. Now it's slightly changing and now it's become definitely better in Telugu cinema also. But at that time it has a very set format. There should be these many songs and these are, it's a set format kind of a thing. And in the scripts are mostly revolved around a star who can play a role. So then there is a little, I felt ki there is a little limitation in the kind of stories we can explore. Because when there is a big star involved, then obviously certain stories only can be explored. It's very rare that you can explore different stories. So I felt ki it's very important to, for you, as a starting point, I felt ki I need to explore little more than what is regular format. Maybe I can of course do formatted films also, but that's not my my first love, I felt. So that's why I thought I'll have to explore more. That's why I moved out of Hyderabad and came to Bombay and then trying to do other stuff.
And it worked wonders for you, I guess.
See, if you do efforts, try to do something which you like, I think people will like it.
I think that's, if we talk about Sairat as well, I mean, people love the cinematography of Sairat. Would you say that Sairat established your credibility as a cinematographer on a very huge level?
Definitely, when a film becomes a big hit, a lot of people see, so then your work is appreciated more. So because when people, and it, when it contributes to its commercial success, definitely it will help. There's no doubt about it. And also when it has more like songs and all, then it will be more, because it's seen again and again. So that's how it,
but how do you feel? I mean, you shot a Marathi movie, Sairat, and it, you know, it becomes such a huge blockbuster, and then, you know, a remake is made, somebody remakes it into Hindi. So what's the entire feeling like?
It's good that Marathi films are being remade as Hindi films, because it's always otherwise. Now it's like, it's a good thing, because now even in national level also small region films are being looked at. Because of that, now people are, some of the North Indians are also interested in, outside the state is also interested in Naal. We need to cultivate this kind of thing as a people who come from different states. Like I, when our new Tamil film comes, I'm slightly interested who is the director, who are the actors, anything new in that. So Malayalam films. So it's that interstate exchange and how to get good cinema out of regional cinema. There should be this kind of a interaction, I think, which is very good. So if there's some good film in either Tamil or Telugu or Marathi is made into Hindi, it definitely gives that opportunity for the larger audience to look at the next films which are coming from that language.
Now you have shot South Indian films as well, you have shot Marathi films as well, and now you'll be shooting for a Hindi film as well, for Jhund, starring Mr. Amitabh Bachchan and directed by Mr. Nagraj Manjule. What is the kind of difference that you see between shooting for a South Indian film and a Marathi film comparatively?
for my approach, I don't think there is a difference in approach as a cinematographer, because I approach according to the story and the motion.
Mm-hmm.
So, but in terms of production value, in the production, the approach of the production, I think changes, because if you were talking about Telugu film, then it's most of the films are like, I told you, you know, like there is a actor, actresses who are little stars and all. So, and then there are a set of comedian actors.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's the whole production setup changes.
Mm-hmm.
And then if you talking about a film like Sairat, there's nothing. You are shooting wild. You are seeing it like all over the place. So that is not possible with that kind of a setup. So that's the kind of difference. But as a creative person, as a cinematographer, for me, the approach is quite similar, because I look at it, what the director is seeing, what he wants, and how is he looking at this, what is his intention, either it's in whatever language it is.
Normally we see that, you know, Marathi movies, most of them, they are shot in, you know, the western parts of Maharashtra, and you know, you have shot Naal in Vidarbha, in the Bhandara district. So, was it by design or was it by choice that, you know, was it a marketing strategy that, you know, you shot the film here, what is the requirement of the script?
This milieu of the film is mostly come from my life.
Mm-hmm.
So it's in Vidarbha.
Was it convenient or inconvenient shooting in Vidarbha? Because, you know, there's in western parts of Maharashtra, because films are shot often, there's a certain awareness about it as well. The other kind of things that you need for shooting a film, they are available easily over there. So was it convenient or inconvenient shooting in Vidarbha?
I don't think it's about Vidarbha or any other place about the convenience. Mm-hmm. Because I was looking for a place which I had in my memories in my childhood. Then there is a river, and I need a river which is white river, and I need a village which I wish I had. I was looking at the Google Maps, where is this place, but I wanted to place it here because this is where I was visualizing. So then I found this Vaininganga Nadi, which is equally broad, and then and there's a village there. I couldn't have shot in my village there because it's not convenient. It's very wild, like it's in the middle of forest, and you don't get any hotels or anything for the crew to stay. Here it's convenient, like in, but as of western Maharashtra and Vidarbha, I don't think anywhere if you want to shoot the other side of the hill, even near Pune, it's difficult. Here also it's difficult. So it's about how close you are to the accessible roads. That is what matters. It doesn't matter otherwise. Village people are always welcoming. Here in Vidarbha are welcoming. Western Maharashtra is welcoming. We shot so much in Deool, in small villages here and there, and other stories. So they are also the same. It's about accessibility, I think. It's not about the region.
You have worked with Mr. Nagraj Manjule quite a few times. You have shot his film, Sairat, and you know, he's acting in your film. He has also co-produced the film. So what is the difference between Nagraj Manjule as a co-producer and Nagraj Manjule as a director, or Nagraj Manjule as an actor? What is the difference between them?
As a person, I take him as a friend, and like your closely associated person who we collaborate each other's creative ideas. That's what it is for us, both of us, when you say. But if you specifically take as a producer, as a actor, as a director, of course, yeah, he is very, very, very eloquent in all the places. See, if I say when I'm working with Sairat, he has seen my films, and he knows my nature, and he knows what all I can get it on the plate to the film. So he is very accommodative of that way. That's the kind of direction director. He is very accommodates everybody, and then tries to what other people are saying, and then if he has something, then he will say ki, no, I was looking like this, look at me like this, what do you think? So there is kind of inclusiveness in that. That is very important for a director. Even when I'm directing, that's also should be the part in the British. And as an actor, he is also a person who leaves everything to the director. This is your film, you tell me what to do. I'll do it. If there is anything which I can suggest, I'll suggest. So that is definitely good for as an actor, because the only person on the set who can see the whole film, if there is anybody who can see the whole film, it's the director. Nobody else can see the whole, everybody sees parts. So you have to give it to the director, whoever it is, whether he is good or bad. Once he's director, he's director. So then you have to leave it for the director. That's a very smart way of acting, actually. because he knows exactly. Since in this film particularly, because he's also writing, he knows the character better. Also, as a producer, see, now he is doing what his job is. Like, he's an amazing producer. Who else will you get a producer like this? Who else will get a producer like this? He's everywhere. The whole Maharashtra knows what Naal is now. So it's because of Nagraj. So he can know how to market it. He knows what elements to look at. So if you say what is the role of the producer, I think I'll say ki you see Nagraj and that's what the role of producer is.
Have your friends and family and relatives back at home, they have seen the Marathi films that you have done so far? What are their reviews about the scene? Have they watched Sairat? Have they seen the trailer of Naal? I mean, what are their reviews?
They've seen. Everybody is following definitely what's happening in Naal. Yeah. And they've been in the trailer got reviews in Andhra also. Mm-hmm. And newspaper reviews, digital reviews like you. I get messages, people are looking forward to it. It's very welcoming because a lot of admirers and the people who I admire also. So they're part of the whole campaign.
The jodi that worked on Sairat, they are going to be back again with Jhund. It is going to be shot in Nagpur and it stars Amitabh Bachchan, such a huge megastar. So, do you think that this synergy will work wonders this time as well? And, you know, how excited are you for this film as well? Because, you know, it stars Amitabh Bachchan, such a big film. People are waiting for the, you know, shoot of the film as well.
Definitely. I think we are all excited to work with you.
Are you nervous as well at the same point of time?
Not really, because I generally don't take the pressure of a starstruck pressure on the set.
Okay.
Because my work is to approach from the story side and from the director's point of view. So actors are there. I also feel the actors are there to give it to him only. So I don't generally try not to take a pressure out of the those things. Not that I work with many stars. I work with a couple of stars in my whole thing. But I always feel that key. It's very important to keep your cool on the set and work the way you always work. Of course, you are excited. Who else? Who is not excited to work with Mr. Bachchan?
So, did you meet him? Did you meet Mr. Bachchan?
Not yet.
So great, you're excited to meet him as well.
Yeah, yes.
Thank you so much, Sudhakar Reddy ji, for being at Dialogue at Nation Next. And we really hope that your Marathi film Naal does wonders at the box office. And we wish you all the best for your future endeavors.
Thank you so much.
Subscribe to Nation Next YouTube channel. And press the bell icon to get regular updates from Nation Next.